So the next question that Irene has is, she says, you know, I let my 3-month-old Cora nap on my chest because it really helps with that startle reflex. Sometimes she'll have a startle reflex 10 minutes after her nap starts, and that would normally wake her. But if I have her on my chest, then she sleeps longer. Is this okay? Do I have to stop doing it? I would say, Irene, that everything is okay, right? Nothing is bad, nothing is wrong until it's causing you a problem. So if Cora is napping on your chest and you're awake and you're supervising her naps, you know, and she's sleeping fine and you're okay with it and you're loving that special moment. I still remember my daughter napping on my chest when she was small, and I remember like it was yesterday, and I remember thinking, this is it. This is the point of everything. This is the most beautiful thing I've ever experienced. So if that's where you are, Irene, and you're happy and you're blissed out, then keep on doing it. You know, you're awake and you're supervising her. She's having long, beautiful, restful naps that she needs. I think it's completely fine. It's only when you get to a point where she's not napping so well, or where suddenly you realize, I've gone from this beautiful napping environment to being trapped under a sleeping baby. And now my baby's older and I really have to start getting some things done during the day. You know, I'm behind the things that I need to do, and I can't be trapped under this napping baby all day long. So if you get ever to that point, then I'd say, well, that is a sign that it's time to have her stop napping on your chest. Naps under 6 months old are short and unpredictable. That's just pretty common. So I don't like to be strict with the rules about naps for babies younger than 6 months. My only rule that I would have would be just make sure your baby naps often. So a 3-month-old should be napping every 1 to 2 hours during the day. And you have to find that little sweet spot. So that means throughout the day, from when she wakes up from her last nap, you just look at the clock, you say, okay, it's 12 o'clock. By 1:30, I should be getting her down for another nap. And as long as Cora is napping often throughout the day, it's okay if her naps are a little bit short. What's most important is that she doesn't have too long of an awake time, because that can overtire her and overstimulate her, and makes it harder for her to sleep later. A great way to transition for nap time is to use motion. Motion is a great way of helping babies sleep, especially for daytime naps. So what I would say, Irene, is you could start to use the swing or the stroller for Cora's naps. So, and it often works. Most babies are quite happy to nap well with motion, and it's really easy for them. So once you've hit that awake time, an hour and a half, where you would normally put her on your chest and maybe sit on the couch and watch some TV, if you think I should go about town and I should get some stuff done, then you could plop her in the stroller and you could go for a nice long walk. Chances are, for most babies, if you've hit the right awake time and it's a time they're used to napping every day, if you put her in the stroller and you start walking, then chances are she's gonna fall asleep. So I would do this for several days, and this is a slower, gentler way of kind of gently breaking that association of always having to be on top of mommy to nap. I would use the swing at home or the stroller. You could use the car seat, but the stroller and the swing are a little bit better, just because the car seat, especially for young babies, is usually at such an angle that it's not the best for them sleeping. What you want is to be a little bit closer to lying flat, like you could do in a swing or certainly in the stroller. So I would do that for several days before I then started to try to get Cora napping in the crib. And then again, what I would use is the technique that I described earlier when you were trying to go from bouncing her at bedtime to putting her in the crib. I would go ahead and walk her in the stroller for quite a while until she gets drowsy, and then try to transfer her into the crib. And then shorten that time every day that you do it. It's the long game with that, and I wouldn't push a young baby so much, especially with naps. Again, as long as, you know, they're happening frequently throughout the day, and as long as she's not super fussy all day long and her moods are stable as a baby's moods can be, then I think you're doing okay.